DaVinci Resolve has incredible automated function to automatically detect scene and cut them for you. Let's say that you're getting a single project and the client or whoever, whatever, demanding that you cut it and regrade it or do any kinds of additional effects to your scene. Well, DaVinci Resolve can actually cut it for you. It's incredibly easy. All you have to do is just push a few buttons like you see on the screen, and you're pretty much all set. That allows completely new workflow and flexibility in post, that way you no longer have to be shooting raw files across the web or just in general large chunks of data. With that kind of function, you can just send one single timeline, cut it on your end, do color grading and shoot it back. As a matter of fact, I've been doing many feature films exactly in the same way and everything been working excellent for me. It's a very convenient and fast way to exchange chunks of data, especially if you're on a crunchy timeline. Not many of us know, but DaVinci Resolve actually has a built-in function that you can use to completely delete some of the objects in your scene. Now, I'm not talking about new object delete function. I'm actually talking about the original old-school method you can utilize to delete unwanted objects in your scene. Now, of course, this method has a lot of limitation. However, it works excellent and very easy to set up. All you have to do, select the object, make sure to track it down, go to the node sizing, select key lock, and use tilt or pan to offset, sort of grab that surface that you can use or fake. Make sure to add a little bit fatter, and you're absolutely done. This trick works like a charm, and I bet some of you guys didn't know about it. Another little gold nugget in my collection is the clean feed, meaning you can use your second monitor now to output full screen. That's right, you heard me right. DaVinci Resolve 16 finally added the function that you can use any monitor for full screen preview without the need of the actual decklink card. For number 4, we have Broadcast Save. It's an amazing function built in DaVinci Resolve that allows you to monitor saturation and luminosity of your footage depending on the color space you're working with. Rec. 709, P3, Rec. 2020, or any other potential color space you may be working. Basically, it's a visual representation of the both colors, blue and yellow, representing luminosity and the saturation on your screen. That way you can visually monitor and see which area of your image is too saturated or too bright, depending on the strength of the broadcast signal you select. Render cache is a fantastic function within DaVinci Resolve that allows you to cache your heavy file raw, or maybe color grading with a noise reduction that you normally can't play back in real time. So this function caches the files in the background in a smaller format and allows you to play it back in real time. That way you can see exactly what you're doing. If you guys enjoyed this video, please hit the like button, consider subscribing, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care.